Two of the most common reasons people go to the dentist are for cavities and root canals. So what exactly happens? Let's take a look.
Hi, Jenna.
Hi.
Nice to see you. How are you doing?
I'm good.
Dr. John Kinsley is preparing to fill a cavity for 15-year-old Jenna Eakes.
Cavities vary in size from near undetectable, small, medium, large, where it can encompass literally the whole tooth. And it rots the tooth and decomposes the tooth.
The process of decay begins with eating. All the drinks and food we consume coat our teeth with plaque, which you may not realize is mostly live bacteria. Failure to remove it with regular brushing and flossing causes a buildup. Sugary and starchy substances are particularly harmful because they allow certain bacteria, dentists call the sugar bugs, to thrive.
And these bugs have the ability to process that sucrose into long chains that create these matrices that they colonize and live on. And they start to build a biofilm on the tooth. And then they process the sugar further and they produce lactic acid. And that lactic acid stays there and starts destroying the enamel.
Once acid eats through the enamel, decay penetrates into the softer layer of the tooth, forming a hole or cavity.
It's almost like a pothole. So a cavity is at the pothole, and we're going to try to resurface it and restore it back to its original shape. How's the numbness now? How do you feel?
Pretty numb.
Dr. Kinsley begins by using a drill to remove the decay. A digital reader indicates if he dug deep enough.
So there's the cavity right there, where it's white.
Next, Dr. Kinsley uses a special dye to make sure all the decay is gone.
We're going to stain it with a dye. Okay, and this is a cavity stain. How are you holding up?
I'm good.
Now it's time to fill the hole. In the past, doctors used mostly silver fillings. But with public concern about mercury in silver fillings, and with the development of newer materials, many dentists now use composite resin, comprised of tooth-colored plastic and glass.
It's plastic that we can form, shape, sculpt, and within about a minute, it's rock hard and it's very strong and it bonds to the tooth.
The bonding with composites means dentists have to take out less of the tooth. Composites are, however, more expensive than silver fillings. But for Jenna Eakes, they do the trick.
Good thing we got that, huh?
Yeah.
Hi, Dan.
Hi.
How are you? Good. How are you doing today?
Dan Jones is about to go through a more extensive and dreaded procedure. Each year, dentists perform about 15 million root canals.
A dental root canal is a procedure that we do to treat a tooth that has become infected either by decay, by trauma from maybe a fall or an injury or a blow to the mouth.
Let's say a cavity is not caught in time. The decay continues into the innermost chamber of the tooth, known as the pulp, which contains the nerves. Once the pulp becomes infected, an abscess forms at the tip, damaging the bone and causing considerable pain.
It's almost like the tooth constantly getting pounded on. It's bruised, it's inflamed, it hurts now, and it's irreversible.
In order to save the tooth, the chamber and its canals must be cleaned out, filled with a cement and rubber-like material, and sealed off.
Can you feel some of the anesthetic already starting to kick in? Okay. Where are you feeling it right now?
My left leg.
Your left leg there, okay.
No.
Dr. Kinsley first numbs the affected area with Novocaine so he can drill deep into the tooth. He irrigates the canals, then uses a camera probe in the mouth to make sure the space is clear of bacteria before sealing it off. Many root canals require multiple visits so that a crown, also known as a cap, made of gold, other metals, or porcelain, can be placed over the damaged tooth to restore it.
Okay, Dan, now the root canal is completely sealed up.
Cavities and root canals are but two of the consequences of sugar bugs and plaque that live on teeth.